Now we're going to look at one of my 2018 Peterbilt 389 flat tops. This one is in legendary red metallic. Has a Cummins X15 565 under the hood, 1850 torque with a 18-speed transmission. 280-inch wheelbase. Sitting on low pro 24/5 Bridgestones all the way around. Low air leaf suspension. Three axle disc brakes, which I believe is one of the best upgrades you can get. That's a little bit of money up front, but you'll next to never put brakes on this truck. 336 rear ends. Holland FW35 fifth wheel with a 36-inch air slide. Depending on your application, this fifth wheel and leg setup should work for you. But if we need to change these legs, I keep all these legs so we can get the height up or down, whatever you need. So don't ever let that be a concern. Low air leaf suspension. Pogo sticks chromed, dual seven ways. Inch Hodge build, deep drop quarter fenders. And I've said that on the 18s, they finally started moving them from this front post back. I like that. It tucks it up against the tire. It's a little bit cleaner look. Six lights in the back of the sleeper. Antenna moved to the top of the back of the sleeper. Took it off the mirrors, just trying to make things look cleaner. I think it's a better look. Still don't have a sliding window available from the factory. Never did hear why they took that away from us, but it is the tinted rear window. Cabin sleeper R air ride. These locking step boxes on both sides, toolboxes, they're polished. Polished 100-gallon fuel tank on this side with polished straps. As always, locking fuel caps. And, since those caps are over $100 a piece, and what's inside is a lot more, I think the locks are smart money. Factory wiring harness on this Phoenix LED light kit. It comes wired from the factory. When my guys install it's all just plug and play. All weathers tight, sealed connectors, nothing, no splices, no butt connectors, no black tape, just nice pieces, and keep it as trouble worry free as possible. Polished stainless DEF tank cover, polished elbows on the exhaust. That's another little touch that a lot of dealers overlook. I've got the 7-inch miter cut tips on this one. I can't always do it. I've got a little selection of exhaust tips. If you like the curved tip better, you need something taller or whatever. If I can trade them out for free, I will. I never mind doing that. If I need to get the factory ones to replace it, I'll give them to you at my cost. Battery box has the disconnect switch. Kills all the power to everything if it's going to be parked for a little while. You see the holes. If you want to put a lock on it or something, you can. Polished battery box. I do the four batteries, not the three. Again, for not much more money when it's new, you can just have that extra bit of protection or reliability, however you want to look at it, you know. Front and rear air cleaner lights on both sides of this premium 15-inch air cleaner. That is the nicest air cleaner you can get. There is two versions. Legendary red metallic. This paint is also another little upcharge. That's why you don't see a lot of dealers carrying it. They're afraid that customers won't pay for it, but my guys that have bought it, the legendary colors, whether it's brown or blue, silver, red, whatever, just loving the compliments they get. Just go on for days. Well worth the investment, I think.
20-inch blind mount, boxed-in bumper, polished rim, polished headlights.
Had my guys put on a 12-inch blind mount drop visor and put clear marker lights. Of course, came from the factory with 5 marker lights, and I had them do 2 more.
Polished step on this side.
You know, with 18, with the new X15, the DPF filter in there is much, much smaller and has a much larger cleaning interval. Of course, we don't have them up there yet, but Cummins is expecting, you know, somewhere around 500,000. So if you only clean it once or twice through 1,000,000 miles, that's sure going to be nice.
Tanks and straps on this 135 gallon tank over here. Again, the wheelbase is 280.
Little shot of the gray platinum interior. X15, which if you've done homework on it, it's the ISX without as much stuff on it, for lack of a better term. Less sensors. It doesn't have the doser at the rear anymore. It's only got a doser on the DEF tank. Much simpler, better air compressor. Not that there's anything wrong with the old one. And by trimming up the emissions, that's where the extra horsepower comes from. It's not struggling to work with the emissions so much. So it what was the 550 is now the 565. So that's a nice bonus. Heated fuel water separate fuel filter water separator. All the fuel lines are Arctic wrapped. I've got the extra insulation in the cabin sleeper. With summer right around the corner, that's where that option really shines. Pre-wired for fog lights or road lights. Just plug and play. There, if you want to add anything, of course, remote lube. Greasable pins on the front springs. Arctic gray platinum interior,
gray carpet, gray seats.
If you don't like the gray seats, I've got them in black. Be more than happy to swap them out for you. Keyless entry. Tilt and telescope column. Something that's always a big hit. 23 real gauges, no navigation, full rosewood dash. Still get the XM satellite radio, hands-tooth, Bluetooth, hands-free, all that still available, or still part of the deal. factory CB. I've got some, they're not true train horns, but there's some horns mounted under the cab that we put on since we don't do the horns. Premium mattress. There's the platinum moniker with a little more storage there. Of course, the bunk lifts up. The workstation also seems to be a very popular option. Everybody really likes it. Whether it's storage or file storage or just a nice place to sit on the edge of the bed here and do your books or get out the laptop, whatever it is you need to do. And there's all your controls from the sleeper. Hanging closet. More storage up here. Of course, it's got the curtain. As always, my name's Steve Carboni. You can reach me anytime, 918-808-5638. You can call me or text me anytime. If you've got a trade, we can talk about your trade. If you need financing, I can help you with that. Not much you can throw at me that I don't think I can help you with. I've been doing this almost 20 years. So I've seen a lot, and glad to say I've made a lot of good relationships in this business. So if I can help you, let me know, and we'll see you guys on the next truck. Appreciate y'all.